It's a superstar Saturday night. We're bringing you to one of the most storied dirt tracks in the country, where a local legendary father and son with the last name Blaney will clash among the biggest stars in all of racing, including the winner of last year's season finale, this guy, yep, Chase Elliott.
Drivers, start your engines!
Watch me, here we go. Buckle up, it's season two of the Superstar Racing Experience. This place is fast, it can be mean.
Short track, short uses, tension.
Kasper Evans wins the checkered flag. Peely goes to Tony Stewart.
Tonight, a little slice of dirt racing heaven.
Oh boy, here we go.
Man, this is gonna be fun.
Come on.
Who gets the job? They're still bumping and banging.
You're good, you're good, you're good.
We're not done yet. Are you ready to light this thing up? Watch me.
No, we are not done yet. We can say hello and welcome to the Camping World SRX series on CBS tonight. In our series finale, we will be crowning a champion, and we are so excited to tell you, but for the second week in a row, we are racing on dirt. We are on the red clay here in Sharon Speedway in Eastern Ohio. This track, and as I bring in my friend, this town is home to the legendary racing family, the Blaneys. They've already broken out the shirts. They've dubbed it Battle of the Blaneys because son Ryan will be racing his father, Dave, and I can tell you the chanting has already begun. So now it's time to tell you a little bit about how it all started for the Blaneys. It started with Lou Blaney, who began it all introducing his family alongside his wife to his love of racing and the track. His sons Dave and Dale both following him into racing. Dale, also a prolific basketball player, by the way, but Dave ran several years in the NASCAR Cup Series, where his son Ryan is in the midst of a successful seventh season. Tonight, it's bragging rights for sure for father and son. Ryan standing by with Matt Yocum.
It certainly is a Christmas in July, Christmas card type moment for the Blaney family. Now, you had a chance last year to see the Elliots have their special night in Nashville. What are you looking forward to most tonight racing against your dad?
There's a lot to look forward to. Obviously, getting to race against him is one of the coolest things, but being here at Sharon, that's meant so much to my family, my dad, my grandpa over the years. They grew up 5 miles from here, so I came here all the time as a kid and answered phones and things like that and gave away, brochures and stuff here. So, and to see how many people have come out for tonight, I mean, it's sold out here. Everyone here is super excited to see us race, not only me and my dad, but all these great race car drivers that come out here. So appreciate everybody coming out. Looking forward to racing dad. Hopefully I can keep up. And I'm excited to get this first heat race going.
Now for the second half of the family reunion, here's my pal Willie T.
I'm here with Big Daddy, Dave Blaney, and he's racing his son on his own track, the track that he owns. How are you going to handle Junior?
I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I told him many times here, the pressure's squarely on him. If he can't beat an old man, he's got issues. So I think we'll both have to worry about the rest of the guys, but hope it's fun for everybody, actually.
I'd love to race my son.
What would happen?
He'd whip me. Back to you, Lindsay.
Thank you, Willie. It's time now to go racing. For the command to start engines, let's send it to family matriarch, mother of Dave and Dale, grandmother to Ryan, Mrs. Katie Blaney.
Drivers, start your engines.
Thanks. Super excited to have Joey here with us tonight. A little montage here, including your success winning a cup race on the dirt at Bristol. Now, you watched with the rest of us last Saturday night. These superstars race on the dirt in Peely, Missouri, and tear up just about every one of the cars in the field. What are we going to see tonight?
Probably the same thing. All the drivers I talked to before I came up here to the booth said it is super slick. It's like going through those go-kart tracks where they put the baby powder down and you're sliding all over the place. They're not going fast. They might get the 40 to 50% throttle, so they got way too much power. It's definitely going to be a handful for them. So keeping your car in that one piece is going to be key, especially through these heat races.
Especially through the heat races. There are no backup cars available for any of the drivers tonight if something happens in the heats. 13, ready to go. Here's how they start. Random draw for the start. So Michael Waltrip is on pole position.
They got Rocket Man Ryan Newman running for the championship tonight alongside Ryan Hunter-Reay from the IndyCar Series and Paul Tracy as well.
PT's car a little different color tonight. More on that in a moment. Matt Kenseth and Bobby Labonte going to be back starting 5th and 6th in our first heat.
And then you got Ryan Blaney, YRB. He's in town along with Greg Biffle. It's going to be fun to watch those two.
TK, Tony Kanaan with Marco Andretti in row number 5. And it is Chase.
That's right, Chase Elliott coming. I flew with him over here. And then you got the old man, Dave Blaney, trying to go after his son, along with Tony Stewart, who you probably would assume is the favorite tonight. Coming from the back is going to be fun to watch him.
Now, I know you know from watching, you can take that radio microphone and talk to any one of these 13 drivers at any time during the night. Who you want to talk to now?
Well, let's talk to Rocket Man Ryan Newman. He's starting up front here. Ryan Newman, Joey Logano up here in the booth. You got me?
I got you, Joey.
Hey, man, you're starting up front. You got Mikey Waltrip on the inside. That's a scary thought, but I think it'll be all right. You got the championship on the line. They're going to invert the field on the finish here. So how are you going to keep this thing in one piece, not in just this heat race, but the second heat race?
Well, the track, you know, the track looks, it's all new to me, but the track looks pretty slippery. So a little bit of moisture down from the very bottom. We're just going to try to make a good race of it. It's an honor to be racing in this SRX series. Had a lot of fun, and I want to finish it on a good note, so we'll see.
All right, well, good luck.
Thanks, sir.
Side note on Ryan Newman. He was like the jokester at the driver's meeting earlier today. He had all the pokes at everybody. It was a lot of fun.
That sounds right.
There is the SRX Championship on the line tonight. And our format, as always, 2 12-minute timed heat races. Start of the first at random. Invert the finish of the first to start the second. The average finish of the two heat races is where you will line up for the main event.
And this track is going to change a lot. They've been watering down this racetrack. There hasn't been, you know, just their cars practicing out there earlier. So the track's going to change as they got all these cars out here sliding around. And then you're going to start again 12 minutes later where you have more laps on the track, so it gets slicker. So the bottom may be the preferred place to start. The top may come in later. We'll have to kind of wait and see, but you're going to have to adapt as a driver. You're going to have to adapt quickly as you know, drivers are moving around. And hey, you don't have spotters to tell you where they all are. You got to figure it out while you're watching.
Pace cars off. These fans, they've been packing in here since they opened the gates. The tickets are all sold out. They want to see one of their local heroes, perhaps, win against the superstars of the SRX series. Here they come. Heat race number 1 is under the green flag. That's Paul Tracy in the lavender car looking to the outside in the first couple of corners.
You can already tell this track's going to be pretty wide. They're leaning on each other already.
I think we're going to see a lot of that tonight. Look at the slide job for Michael Waltrip.
Oh, he's got that thing all crossed up. Look at him all the way across the racetrack, crossing each other back and forth, Ryan Newman back down to the inside. And they all told me, don't expect a lot of speed here. This is going to be all about being very technical, easy on the throttle, easy at the brake and the steering. This is not a hammer down racetrack. It's going to be nice and easy. Look at
him. It's going to take 5 cars, possibly, into this one incident.
And it's like a slow-motion crash. They see it coming, but you can't stop. And you see a bunch of hitters in this one. Ryan Blaney with a lot of damage. Hopefully it's just cosmetic.
Ryan Blaney, Matt Kenseth, Tony Kanaan, and Chase Elliott. So that is Tracy to the inside of Michael Waltrip, and they just couldn't save it.
It looks like Tracy sends it in there hard and a little doink to the right side.
Early mayhem on a Saturday night at Sharon Speedway.
Camp for less at Camping World. Right now, get a new Coleman Lantern 17B, ice camping starter kit, 2 years of Good Sam Road Rescue, and a 3-year Good Sam RV warranty for just $149 a month. That's less than $5 a day. Plus, we have the best selection of camping and RV supplies, starting at just $9.99. We've got an RV for every lifestyle and a payment for every budget. Camping has never been more affordable. You always camp for less at Camping World. Click, call, or come into your local Camping World today.
Okay, snacks and popcorn are going to be expensive. Let's just accept that.
Going to the movies can be a lot for young homeowners turning into their parents.
Bathrooms, even if you don't have to go, you should try.
We all know where the bathroom is and how to use it. Okay?
You know, the Stevensons told me they save money bundling their boat insurance with Progressive.
No one knows who those people are. It can be painful.
Hand me your coat. There's an extra seat in here.
No. We don't need a coat wrangler.
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home, auto, and more with us.
No one who made the movies here.
Can I get it mic'd away? What's happening? And your free sub. Enjoy.
Thanks. That was super weird.
Oh, that?
Nah.
She just used the shore points you can now earn from chip and drink purchases to get free sub through the app. Download the Jersey Mike's app and earn rewards towards free subs with every sub, Pepsi, and Lay's you purchase.
Here's to those with homework this summer, group projects, and workshops. Here's to those with morning meetings, networking events, and Zoom sessions. Here's to those with summer jobs and the truck that goes to work with them. Ram, built to serve.
Every dollar counts these days, so take advantage of this great offer from Ram Trucks.
Ryan Blaney's car has gone back to the pit area after this early accident off of turn number 4. Michael Waltrip in the light blue car, Paul Tracy in the lavender car.
And here we are riding along with Paul Tracy as he comes out of the corner here with some momentum and a little bit too much momentum up the racetrack as he slides into Michael Waltrip. Ryan Blaney, nowhere to go. He's just wrapping the bottom nice and easy and nothing he can do about it. Wrong place, wrong time. You can't stop that quick.
Ryan Blaney's group.
He's looking good, wrapping the bottom and just comes right down in front of him. And then one more just for the heck of it. It sounds like the radiator is knocked out of Ryan Blaney, so they're going to try to fix that as quickly as possible.
Now, remember, if you've been with us throughout our series, you've seen it. When a driver gets a car torn up early on in the evening, they'll sometimes just swap his seat out into a backup car and get him back in action. They don't have any backup cars available tonight, Matt, because they damaged so much stuff last week at Peevely.
And right now, Ryan Blaney is looking over the damage to his car. We've got oil on the engine compartment, other fluids. Can you even describe, really, the emotions and the disappointment so few laps in?
Just getting going. I don't know who spun. Someone spun in front of me and come across. I was just creeping around the bottom and come across the bottom, and I don't think it would have been that bad. And I don't know who tagged me in the nose and knocked all the oil lines off of it. So that really stinks. Hate coming out here. A bunch of people in the stands to watch, and we get tore up. So hate it for everybody. Two laps were good, though. Just last one.
Chase Elliott's car went back into the pit area also and has come back onto the racetrack. Here is Chase's view.
Yep. Yep, that's what happened. It's just, like I said, when they start getting sideways and spinning out, and everyone's that close just on the start of the race. No one's really spread out much yet. And like you said, on this dirt, you can't stop very quickly. A lot of these drivers had a lot of rear brake in the car to try to get it to pitch into the corner, help the cars turn. Well, that's good when you're going normal and fast, but when you have to stop quickly with just rear brake, not ideal.
Past halfway in our timed heat race number 1. Haven't seen a whole ton of green flag racing. Let's hope for more right now. Andretti jumps to the inside, and the orange car looks to make it 3 wide.
You see him trying to get that drive down there, looking for the moisture on the racetrack already. See a little bit of dust coming off the back of the cars. That means the track's drying out, and it's going to keep getting slicker like that. Look at him creep around the bottom, Ryan Newman down there.
So Ryan Newman, the leader, Michael Waltrip second. Ryan Hunter-Reay in the black car, Marco Andretti in the orange, side by side for third.
Listen, how easy on the throttle, really barely getting to it. What I notice here, too, right off the bat, Ryan Newman is driving this car like it's on asphalt. His car is the straightest. No yaw on it. No, it's not sideways. It's nice and straight. And you see him able to get that launch off the corner, creeping around the bottom.
Michael Waltrip running the rim around the top. Marco Andretti down the bottom. The white car now in fourth place is Bobby Labonte. And then Ryan Hunter-Reay is side by side with Tony Kanaan for fifth.
I tell you, Michael Waltrip's found something up top. He's got some grip up there. You see him getting the run off the corner.
This is for the race lead. Waltrip in the light blue car. Whoop, hit a little hiccup there, and it might cost him. Ryan Newman back out in front.
You know, the top is hard to run on dirt. You got to be just right about how you get to the throttle, keep the car pitched out to be able to carry the momentum up top so he can get the reward right here down the front straightaway. That's where you're getting the reward by running the top, by carrying more momentum down the straightaway. Racy racetrack. You can tell already when the top and the bottom is that equal.
Yeah.
Very racy.
Side by side, still for the race lead. Newman low, Waltrip high.
Oh, we got to spin. Biffle's around here.
Nope, Greg Biffle is around between turns three and four. No caution yet. Now caution as the field steams down the backstretch.
What a great race. Right off the bat, you see the top like that, the bottom, and seeing the complete opposite lanes. That's what you want to see when you come to a dirt race. Oh. And here you see Biffle getting in there. Dave Blaney might have finished him off.
Yeah, Greg got in there hot, ran up on the back of Paul Tracy, and then, yes, in the jam up.
Not right, much damage, so he's fine. Looks good.
Little left rear chunk of the fiberglass panel there missing.
Don't need that anyway.
Yeah, so with two races on dirt tracks last year and two races on dirt tracks this year, they have been the races with the most yellow flags in all of our SRX events.
Well, it means it's pretty tricky, I guess, to get around there. But I tell you, when they are racing, they're fantastic watching them go back and forth like that. And just only, you know, 2.5 minutes left or so in this, it's going to be a shootout.
Yeah, think about, right, when you got ready to take your NASCAR Cup car dirt track racing, it's not designed for dirt track racing. Well, these SRX cars not only are not designed for dirt track racing, they're not even a left-hand offset oval track chassis. They're a straight-ahead road racing chassis that they run on paved ovals and dirt tracks.
But at least it's the same for everybody.
Absolutely.
It may not do everything the way you want them to do it, and it's not purpose-built for dirt. You see a lot of late models and modified sprint cars. You see, you know, the rear ends are moving a lot. You know, they're trying to find any way to get rear drive in a car with having steer in it somehow. This is not like that. The rear end is fixed. It's not moving around a lot, so you got to use the pedals, and you got to be very soft and smooth with them and drive with the gas pedal. A lot of times when the car is not turning on dirt, what do? You hit the gas more and try to get the rear tire spinning to get it to pitch out.
So Newman and Waltrip lined up side by side here on the front row for the restart with a little over a minute and a half left to go in our timed heat race number one.
And this is going to be good because Newman wants the bottom, Waltrip wants the top. This is going to be a fun race to the end.
Marco Andretti aggressive to the inside of Newman and Orange.
He did that to restart before.
Yes, he did.
Someone needs to pay attention to that.
Newman slammed up into Bobby Labonte, pinched him off. Big traffic jam, and they're going to throw the yellow flag out. I'm not so sure that caution, I'll have to confirm, is a waved-off restart from race control.
It might be. We'll have to wait and see. I don't know what the rule is here. Can you pass before the start-finish line?
I do get confirmation from race control. That was a waved off restart. I think Michael basically had a little bit too good of a roll going on Ryan Newman, who was the control car for the restart.
So you think it's Waltrip? So I was thinking it might have been Andretti with that move so early. So maybe it was both.
either way, waved off, re-racked for a restart. That will come, from what we're told, we'll get a minimum of 2 laps here to under the green flag to finish this heat race number one.
Okay.
So that was the one to go signal. So we'll do the old green-white checker to finish up our heat race.
Well, that'll make it even more exciting. So if I'm Ryan Newman now, I got to be, you know, pretty aware of what Andretti did last time. You already see him. He's laying back a little bit. He's trying to time a run. Newman's going to adjust to that.
Yeah, and did. There he goes. Green flag with two laps to go in this heat.
Newman said, I'll go early this time. That worked out just fine.
Big break for Bobby Labonte in that, too. Remember your average finish in the two heats. Bobby had gotten shoved wide when Newman got knocked up the track, so good break for him. So it's Andretti down low, Waltrip up high. They're knocking around back behind him as they get the white flag in our first heat.
And Newman and Andretti, they're racing for the championship here tonight. So it's very important for them to race near each other. Newman's trying to make about 8 points on Andretti. So this is a good race. They're getting points for the heat race as well.
Checkered flag is out at the end of heat race number one. Ryan Newman will win it. Michael Waltrip second. Marco Andretti third. Bobby Labonte fourth. And Tony Kanaan edges Ryan Hunter-Reay for fifth. Well, it's what we thought it would be. It's slick, it's tough.
And some bumping and banging.
And we've already torn up a couple cars. And we're just getting started. Heat race number one is done at Sharon Speedway in Eastern Ohio. It was won by the Rocket Man, Ryan Newman.
Camping World SRX Series on CBS Sports is sponsored by Progressive. Save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance. And by Camping World. Camp for less with Camping World.
It is a superstar Saturday night. What we can tell you is it's been action on the track right now, and it's also been a very busy garage area. Let's take a look at the results here of Heat 1. Ryan Newman taking the lead late, Michael Waltrip, then Marco Andretti coming up third. One of the guys we've seen that still is having work done to his race car is Matt Kenseth. He is with our Willie T Ribs.
Matt Kenseth, slick dirt track racing. They're working on your piece right now. They're going to get you back.
I hope they'll get it fixed for the feature. So just kind of wrong place at the wrong time. Last week I got a direct hit from Paul coming across the track. And then this week it kind of looked like, watch that replay, just got in the corner way too hard and came back across the track. And there's nowhere for Ryan and I to go. So kind of wrong place at the wrong time.
Well, you're going to be back in there. That's all that matters. Lindsay.
Willie T. Ribs, thank you. We just heard Kenseth talking about it. It's this red clay that makes this track so challenging. It's the history here that makes it so special. This racetrack opened almost a century ago. Here's more on the track and Progressive at the track.
Oh, there's so much history in this racetrack. The actual first race here was 1929. This is the oldest continuing running racetrack, and this will be our 93rd year. Even with World War I and II, they still ran at least one race a year.
Dave Blaney, who is a retired NASCAR driver, and his son Ryan races in NASCAR. Dave Blaney is one of the owners, along with Jim Weller, who's a local businessman, and Ron Carrillo. And they purchased the racetrack in 2001 after the season and took it over in 2002, shortened it to a 3/8 mile, and they've owned it ever since.
My name is Kate Blaney. I'm Lou Blaney's wife, mother of David and Dale, and grandmother of Ryan, all whom have raced in their lifetime here. We went to the races as a family, and they grew up to like it. We started each one in their own car, and of course, Ryan is of a different generation.
Dave Blaney's going to race against his son, Ryan Blaney, and I hope to get the bang fenders a little bit out there. And Dave's going to want to win. He ain't going to want to give nothing to Ryan, for sure. And then, of course, Ryan, you know, Ryan doesn't race a lot on dirt, and he's going to want to show his dad up on dirt. So I think it's going to be super cool to see Dave Blaney and Ryan Blaney race against each other here.
This is actually red clay. It's the best. It really is. There's no rocks in it. It does not eat race tires up. And when we put this surface on, it just changed the complexity of the outlook of all our drivers and people that support this place.
Until you actually race on it, a lot of people don't really know. It's a different animal. It's technical and a lot more technical than a lot of places, and it takes a little bit of time to figure it out.
It's a two-hour Big Brother event in Eviction, a new head of household, new nominations, and a game-changing twist all in one night. Don't miss the Big Brother event, new tomorrow on CBS. CBS. You know, anytime we come to these racetracks, besides interviewing drivers, Willie T. Ribbs loves to check out the local flavor. A lot of you probably know the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is in Cleveland. Well, did you know that the local vocal group Hall of Fame is right nearby? Willie went to check it out.
Where we at?
We're here in Sharon, Pennsylvania. Vocal Group Hall of Fame. Right down the road is a Cleveland Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Unbelievable facility. It's been here, what, the building 100 years?
100 years.
Right?
Well, the theater is 100 years old. It was originally built for vaudeville and performing by orchestras and all kinds of acts.
Because they would have shows that traveled the country, and this was one of their stops.
What has this Hall of Fame done for Sharon?
It all started with a guy named Tony Butala, who went on to become the Letterman, their singing group.
Yeah.
He's from Sharon, and it was his dream to do this years ago.
What is the requirement for getting into the Vocal Hall of Fame besides having a good voice?
You gotta harmonize, three people harmonizing. You gotta be in the music business 10 years at least, have a number one record.
If you look at the long list, we have everything from the Beatles to the Supremes, Beach Boys, have all been inducted here.
Well, I when I drove into town, everyone knew this place. Everyone. It was like the hallmark of Sharon.
The hallmark of Sharon. You should see the list of vocal groups that are in that Hall of Fame. We've got so much more to come here on the Camping World SRX series on CBS. Stay with us. Heat 2 just after the break. Underway on the track for Heat 2. Alan Bestwick and Joey Logano are up in the booth. Guys, what are you expecting to see in this heat?
More mayhem?
Oh, if you thought the first heat was a cluster, now you have the fastest car starting in the back. They inverted the field, and you have the cars that may have had some issues. You see Paul Tracy with some damage. Dave Blaney on the outside, he's been working a top end, so I think I know what he's thinking on the start here. But you're going to see these cars drive through the field. It's going to be fun. Michael Waltrip, you see him in the back there. He's going to start wanting to rock the top right off the bat. That's where he's been the fastest. Newman's going to creep the bottom. This is going to be a fun heat race. They got 12 minutes to work their way all the way back through the field.
So pace car is off. Paul Tracy's car had been lime green. This is a lavender color. I asked Paul what's up. He said it's a kinder, gentler man.
Yeah, I don't think so. Not from what I saw the first heat race, he is the same driver.
Green flag, and heat race number 2 is underway here at Sharon Speedway. It's Dave Blaney outside in the black car, and Paul Tracy sliding inside him in lavender. Michael Waltrip jumped the cushion up in turns 1 and 2. He is slow off the corner, but is still under green.
See the right front fender off that car as well. It's Dave up top. Here's Michael running a little bit high. You see him get into the wall and just rips the fender right off that thing.
Yeah.
Wow. Now this is where he's been running all day. So if he gets up there, it's a little too much. And it's a little... When you get a little bit too high in the dirt, there's a part where there's grip, and then you get a little too much, and you just kind of, some of the dirt guys call it crumbs. I don't know what you call it, but it's no grip. Whatever you want to call it, it's the dirt version of marbles, I believe, and then you get too high and you get sucked into the wall.
All right, this is fun. Dave Blaney, track co-owner, the Buckeye Bullet, leading the race way up high. Greg Biffle, looking ahead at him, has taken a clod of clay right on the camera lens.
Yeah, tear off on the camera lens. But you see how this track is changing, right? We talked about how it's going to change as these races go along. Now the top looks very dominant. Top two cars up here running, I say that, as here Chase Elliott's Chase, on the bottom, creeping the bottom, running well.
That is Tony Kanaan in the bottom in the pink car also, trying to follow Chase Elliott through. Someone asked me how much experience Chase Elliott had racing on the dirt. I said, more than you think.
Well, he's been racing those midgets on the dirt quite a bit. I know I see that on social media a lot. So he's got some experience, and he's also been racing stock cars for a long time as well. So you can see the guys on the bottom, they're all very straight. up top. See Dave Blaney up there? He's got it sideways. He's on the gas. Down the bottom, creeping. And that could also help your tires, right? You're up top, you're on the gas sideways, you're burning your rears up. At the bottom, Chase Elliott's going to have some tire left on this thing.
Ryan Newman is making some progress through the field. Watch Dave Blaney here. Just slinging it sideways.
It's like he knows the racetrack.
You think?
He owns it.
He knows every inch of this racetrack. So Chase Elliott making some progress in that red car down low. Dave Blaney is up top.
Yo, this is pretty fun to watch. Just the different lines, but also watching Dave Blaney race against Chase. Chase and Ryan Blaney are best of friends. You know they're always hanging out together.
Yeah.
Pretty cool to see all this kind of show up on the racetrack.
Dave Blaney's resume, 1984 USAC Silver Crown champion, 1995 World of Outlaws champion, 95 career World of Outlaw wins, member of the National Sprint Car Hall of Fame. That's all before he went cup racing.
Not too bad. A lot of dirt experience here. You look at the run he's getting on the top and being able to clear Chase. Chase needs the whole racetrack to keep that momentum going. So I think Chase has the faster car and maybe a faster line, but it's not enough to quite clear Dave Blaney. Listen to Bobby. Listen to the throttle in here.
Here's our live telemetry on Bobby Labonte. Let's see how hard he's working back there in sixth place.
The engine's not working hard, I can promise you that. You don't need the power here.
Bobby running in sixth position while Chase Elliott continues to chase Dave Blaney for the race lead. He was up underneath him a time or two while we were looking at Bobby's telemetry, but old Buckeye Bullet on the outside, he just manages to find a way to stay out in front.
Yeah, he's making it work. I was watching on the track here, and I saw Chase Elliott try to move up top and do what Dave Blaney was doing, and he lost a ton of ground. Yeah. But look, when he went back to the bottom, he's running back down so quick, it's just going to be hard to pass Dave, and he's like a machine up there. His car does the same thing every time. He's not making a mistake. He's just running the race like he knows how to, like he's done probably a million laps around here.
Right behind them, Greg Biffle is in third, Tony Kanaan is fourth, and Ryan Newman has moved up to fifth, while Chase Elliott goes after Dave Blaney again. We check with Matt. Oh, got trouble off turn four. And is Paul Tracy around as he and Ryan Hunter-Reay have tangled? So from PT's view, might have had a little help with that.
Might have.
But that might have been from a little tag at the other end of the racetrack seconds before.
Most likely.
Those things tend to work that way, yeah.
Our passion for protecting vehicles started in 1934. And we've been pushing the limits of performance ever since. We innovate with the times and have the trusted filters to fit your needs. Yeah, we've been around the block, but our journey is just beginning. Fram for the road ahead. Find Fram True Air Premium Cabin Air Filters at Walmart.
It's true. Everyone gets a free new Samsung Galaxy S22 with a Galaxy trade-in. Any year, any condition.
Really? Even if my old phone looks like this?
Dude, why?
Good. It's okay, people. I've trained for this.
It's not complicated. New and existing customers get a free new Samsung Galaxy S22 with the Galaxy trade-in. Any year, any condition.
Use only your mind. Place the order. Now.
Order up for Dustin.
I don't have any money.
Whoa.
What if somebody ordered pizza with their mind?
Actually, now there is a way to order pizza with your mind.
What?
With the new Domino's Mind Ordering app.
This is Frank. He runs a sustainable camping supply business. He's smiling because FedEx is growing its fleet of electric vehicles. And these are the Camper Scouts, earning their Eco Badge. They're sharing this news to their global Scout community, which, unexpectedly, has made Frank quite popular. So it's a good thing Frank uses FedEx to help him expand his reach and make Earth a priority. FedEx, where now meets next.
After a thunder and lightning downpour earlier today, it has become a beautiful night here in northeastern Ohio at Sharon Speedway. Our Camping World SRX Series season finale, heat race number 2, getting ready to come back to the green flag in a minute. With Dave Blaney, the leader, choosing the outside lane, and Chase Elliott taking the inside. Watch at the back of the pack here. This is the Hunter Ray Paul Tracy incident.
Yeah, I believe he had a... I think there's retaliation in there from something at another point because he had a... he was aiming for him, from what I see.
He had radar locked? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, for sure. It was on him. And they were racing for last.
Yeah.
So, not an ideal situation to be in.
Let's check with Matt Yoakum.
And the color change didn't help either, so didn't catch a break there. But Chase Elliott, the one thing he noticed when he got a few laps in a practice about 90 minutes before this event, he said the big thing he noticed, he's got to keep the car much more straight. Joey, it's much more like driving on pavement versus a wing 410 sprint car that Dave is accustomed to driving. Going in there and get the thing sideways on that right rear. Keep the car straighter. Remember, these are the K&N NASCAR tires, so they prefer to be a little bit gingerly raced and keep it more straight.
Yeah, part of that is because of the line that they're running, right? Chase on the bottom wants to keep that thing straight. And Blaney up top, he wants to have it crossed up sideways, keep that momentum. So just two different styles and two different lines.
Green flag, here we go.
Big launch by Dave Blaney. You see him getting out there and clearing himself.
Watch Ryan Newman in that navy blue car with the big gold Sun Outdoors decal on the hood. He's moved up from last at the start of this heat race, which was 11th on the racetrack. And he's working his way around Chase Elliott for second spot if he can.
He's kind of in no man's land. He's in that middle. What we've seen work so far is the extremes, the extreme bottom, extreme top. And Newman's just kind of in no man's land because we got one in the fence back there.
That's Biffle jumped the cushion. And I'm sorry, it wasn't Chase Elliott, it was Tony Kanaan, by the way. But yes, the Biff jumped the cushion, but he continues. So here we go, Dave Blaney in the black car, Chase Elliott in the red car. Tony Kanaan running third.
And this is nothing like anything he's ever driven before. I was talking to Tony before I came up here. I was like, what can you tell me? He's like, it's slick. And I hope I don't spin out. That's what he said. If he moves up, I spin out. I'm stuck on the bottom. Here we go, Tracy with getting in the back of Hunter Ray. We saw that drama there before. It's going to keep going, I believe.
Watch the gold car. Biffle just gets a little too high and catches that guardrail on the outside of the track. Chase Elliott making some ground, and he's going to have the lead on Dave Blaney this time, if momentarily.
Yeah, that's a great shot where you can see the different styles. You can see Chase on the bottom and straight, Blaney up top, sideways, hanging it up against the wall. Now with Dave Blaney behind, it'll be interesting to see how he adjusts and what he does differently. Because it looks like he is not checking up any. He might be running harder now. Look at him sideways down the straightaway up against the wall when he enters. He wants to get that young kid up there.
He's committed. Yeah, listen to how gently Chase is on the gas here.
I don't think he's getting more than 25% throttle. Listen to this off the corner. Oh, we changed it.
Very determined to stick the bottom. And Dave Blaney, maybe just, you were talking about being hard on your tires, being out there in that outside lane, maybe just doesn't quite have enough left to keep Chase behind him.
Could have been it. Nice and easy, nice and smooth.
Now, Dave is racing Tony Kanaan for second.
What I see is the parity in these cars. Obviously, obviously they're all very similar with different driving styles and maybe drivers asking for different things, but you know, Ryan Newman had a very fast car at the first race. You see him now, he's come up through the field some, but he's kind of stopped. And so that just tells me track position is going to be important. How you get through these heat races is key in making sure you get yourself to the front.
Oh, Blaney just jumped the cushion and scuffed the wall. He's going to lose second, third, and now be fighting with Ryan Newman for fourth as Chase Elliott comes around turn number four to the checkered flag. And a heat race win here at Sharon Speedway. Elliott, Kanaan, Labonte, Newman, and then Dave Blaney, who led most of that heat race, but just couldn't hang on at the end.
Makes you wonder, is it tire wear or what it was that happened for Dave Blaney? Once he lost that track position, it kind of fell apart for him.
Now, Chase Elliott joined us for our SRX finale a year ago in Nashville. Got to race his dad, Bill, that night. Won the main event. Here, he's racing at the Blaney's track. And he's won the heat race. He'll be one of the ones to watch in our main event that comes up in just a little bit.
Welcome back to the Camping World SRX series on CBS. Everyone loves a bus jump, don't you? Fireworks, this is how we roll here at CBS with this Camping World SRX series. So much fun going on there in the infield. We certainly also saw fireworks on the racetrack. Let's give you a look now at the results for Heat 2. Chase Elliott taking the honors there, followed by Tony Kanaan, who worked his way up there. We've got Matt Yocum with Chase Elliott. Matt?
Well, Chase has climbed out. William Clyde, the big Bill, is over off to the side checking out your action here tonight. Exciting. So how would you describe the fun meter so far? Because you've experienced about everything tonight.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun racing with Dave there for the lead. The top still had a little bit of moisture there before that yellow. Then after the yellow, I think, you know, he kind of dusted what was left of it off, and the bottom was kind of the place to be. So curious to see what they do to the track. I don't know if they'll, you know, put some water on it or not. You know, the top is definitely the place to be. But we had a great battle. It was a lot of fun. I kind of wish Ryan was in that position where he could battle with him, but that was pretty cool. So hopefully we can make the right moves here and see where we line up for the future.
All right, let's go to Willie.
I'm with Tony TK Kanaan. TK means knockout, right? 2013 Indy 500 winner. Great job in the heat.
Thanks, Willie T. Yeah, man, we finally got a break. I mean, we're being pretty strong in the heats, but then always something happens in the final. So let's see. The car looks pretty good. I've learned a little bit what to run and what to do. So, I'm excited. Let's see what's going to happen in the end here.
Bet.
All right, Willie T. Ribs, I'll take it. Standing with Ryan Newman. Ryan, you were inching your way up there. What did you find that you think can help you in the main event?
Hopefully track position with our finishes and where we get to start. Really slick racetrack, which is fine. It's like going to a slick go-kart track, and I'm good with that. But
is it fun?
Oh, it's a blast, especially when you got that track position. But it's going to be a little bit beating and banging, I'm sure. And just go out there and have some fun, do our best.
All right, Yocum, who do you have?
Well, I've got somebody who really is multitasking tonight, Dave Blaney. Promoter during the day, but here at night, a driver, a great example of why this place is such a fan favorite. Chase Elliott on the bottom, racing it like it was a pavement track. You're up there almost like you had your wing car.
Yeah, that's what this track shows a lot, and I'm glad we could at least have some two-wide racing. I don't know if the top's going to hold up much longer, but it was fun there for a while.
What changes are you going to ask your crew to make?
We got to tighten way up to get competitive in the bottom half of the track, so we'll see.
All right. The former World of Outlaws champ knows what he needs in that 10 car, Lindsay.
Thank you, Yocum. All right, let's take a look at who you guys think is going to win the main event. We would love for you to weigh in your options. Visit twitter.com/SRX Racing to vote. Tell us who you think, again, is going to win the main event. Cars being adjusted. We're getting ready to see exactly what people are going to do once they get back out there. But we have had so much fun using our bells and whistles with our state-of-the-art technology over the past 6 weeks to take you inside the race cars and also around the track to show you what these drivers are experiencing, even our guys up at the booth. Here's more. Drivers, start your engine! We are ready to go. We got fireworks.
The
joy of seating are the wizards behind these nice little seats.
Quite an appetite driving one of these race cars as you look at our Whoop Live. Calories burned.
I promise you, it's hot and hard work in those cars right now.
Here comes Tony Stewart. The revolutions, the miles per hour. The checkered flag waves tonight over Ryan Newman.
Just to look at some of the things we've been excited to bring you this season. Let's go to Matt Yoakum with Ryan Hunter-Reay.
Well, Ryan Hunter-Reay, overlooking some of the cosmetic damage to the front, the car would be great for the main event. The first two heats, test sessions for you, do you feel pretty comfortable going into the main event?
I started to really get the rhythm of it, running with Tony Stewart there the last few laps, and just understanding just how slick the place is. It moves around a bit. Drinking from a fire hose here, had to deal with PT there, so we won't be having that again. But
you have had some experiences tonight with him. What's going on there with PT? Different colored car. We thought maybe he might be below the radar.
I'm not sure. I don't know. But like I told him, don't hit me. I'm not going to have to do that to you. So we've had a lot of fun together though in this series, and we've got a lot of laughs and. It's just, you want to have a straightforward night, that's what I'm looking forward to. It's been one thing or another every weekend, so I'd really like to have a straightforward night for this Camping World number one car, and these guys work so hard on it. It's great, it's good fun, and I'm enjoying this. At one point, I sat there at the restart, and I remember looking ahead, and I saw Tony Stewart sitting there, Chase Elliott sitting there, and I'm like, man, I'm restarting this thing. Never really haven't been on dirt against two NASCAR champions. It's just, it's awesome. How, where can you do that?
All right, good luck in the main event. The guy he was talking about, PT, he's standing by with our Willie T.
I got Mr. Excitement, Paul Dick Tracy, and he had another run, a rumble with Hunter-Reay, right?
Yeah, I gave him a little bump and run, got by him, and then he just flat out dumped me in the next corner. He's like, don't bump me and I won't have to do that. And I'm like, well, what are we doing here? Are we racing guys or dumping them? So, this track is so slippery and the cars are sideways all the time. And it doesn't take anything. I just gave him a little shot right there. And, that's racing, but dumping guys and turning them around is not part of the deal here,
Well, you know how to go to the dump too.
It's true. The car's in a little bit of rough shape, but I was really hanging on out there. I hope we can tighten it up because I think everybody would say the cars are really, really slippery out there, and we're going to need every bit of these tires for the next 70 laps, I'll tell you that.
Great job.
All right.
Billy T. Ribs, thank you very much. The Blaneys know obviously a lot about what it takes at this racetrack. Coming up, a bit of conversation with the Blaneys, and let me tell you, it's highly entertaining.
Racing family of a lot of years, and not only my dad, but my Uncle Dale, Grandfather Lou. I'd like to continue that tradition as long as I can, and then maybe one day my kids will want to continue it as well.
Welcome back to the Camping World SRX series on CBS. How cute are those faces here to watch this action that we've seen already tonight here at Sharon Speedway on the racetrack. Oh, the puppy's running everywhere. Everyone's looking at it, but these fans are definitely getting what they came out to see. We also, by the way, are hearing good news that Matt Kenseth and Ryan Blaney will be back out on the track at the start of the main event. Ryan Blaney and his dad, Dave, they're known as some of the quieter guys in racing, but Matt Yoakum, I know you had the opportunity to spend some time with them, and I've heard that they were actually the opposite of that.
Well, Lindsay, let's just call it Midwestern Reserve. The Blaneys are known for letting their right foot do the talking more than being boastful of what they can do behind the wheel. But I had a chance to sit down with the Blaneys at Dave's Race Shop in Salisbury, North Carolina, literally about 300 yards down the street from where Ryan began his racing career, racing quarterbench. By the time the afternoon was over, I wanted to lean in and say, okay, who are you and what have you done with Dave and Ryan Blaney? Because it was a lot of fun.
I'm excited to run against each other and like in the same cars, because kind of the same thing. We talk all the time about my stuff, about his sprint cars, stuff like that, but it's kind of hard to compare because I've never really done a lot of sprint car stuff, and the new cars dad hasn't driven in a while,
and we've raced together just a few times in just like celebrity, maybe one real race,
that kind of exhibition celebrity race. We didn't really see each other a lot. I saw you on the last lap, on the last corner. But other than that, I didn't.
Because really, they made me start last.
I know, exactly. I started on the pole.
So was there pressure on you to live up to the Blaney name, so to speak? It's the track, the family.
Oh, I have no
pressure.
You've
got such great dirt experience.
Yeah, I am.
I mean, your resume on dirt is...
It's extensive, isn't it?
I think you have all the pressure. That's how I'm looking at it.
I have zero pressure. Hey, I have all the excuses, too. I've only run up there one time. I have barely any dirt experience. Yeah, I'm going to go in there... not expecting a lot, and so if it does go a little bit better than I expect, then I'm going to be happy about it. So that's how I'm going into this deal.
When you look at him and put your dad hat on, what are you pleased with the most about how he has turned out as a person?
Oh, damn, I have to make a list.
Getting into it, yeah. Yeah, it can't be that long.
For me, he's got it all, right? He's very talented at a lot of different things. Good personality, good kid, good heart, all of it. Actually, all my kids are the same way. And I look in the mirror, and I'm like, man, that came from their mother.
Good thing mom was around, yeah.
So, happy for that.
I mean, as far as the impact in, you know, life and racing, I mean, obviously, I wouldn't be where I'm at without, you know, him, whether it's getting started, obviously, in racing, opening up a lot of doors when I got to, you know, even the late model level, and then especially at the NASCAR side, but then life stuff, you know, personality stuff. And I take a lot from him, whether it's the good or the bad. You know, I feel like I'm kind of a mini dad. Yeah, I think we both have the short fuse gene, but then we were able to reel it back in really quick. It's just one of those things I tell, especially my team, I'm like, hey, I get this from my dad, and
threw it on me.
But hey, I mean, I lived it. I saw it, you know? So, and I'm the same way.
I do want to disagree with a couple things he said, though, as far as me opening doors or something like that. I don't think there was any of it. Through the history of NASCAR, there's been a ton of dads get their kids cars, you know, be able to get together a radio. I mean, it only went forward because of him and what he could do behind the wheel. That was it.
Well, it's got to start, right? I mean, he started it.
Yeah.
Of getting me those chances.
It could have easily went
too
wildly the other direction,
yeah.
And I could have done the same exact things.
What would surprise people to know about him at this stage of his life?
Everybody knows everything about it.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't hold back very much on social media.
If you'll wear the Princess Leia costume and put it out there, I don't think you're hiding it. There's nothing else.
Yeah.
There's nothing else.
Yeah, you know, hey.
That happened. I mean, it was impressive. I'm not gonna lie. How much alcohol did that take?
Surprisingly, it didn't take any. You know, I've done a Halloween party the last 4 years at my house. Kind of become a tradition of everyone dressing up. And I've tried to get him to come to one, and he hasn't. Maybe that could be the bet. If I beat you at Sharon, you got to come dressed up to the Halloween party this year. I don't think he'll take that.
It's pretty steep. I'm going to have to get big odds on that one.
And just don't even come into the house. Just, like, stand.
Yeah, I'm going to stand outside the window.
Yeah. It's good. I know it's coming now. So. I'm like, yeah, don't worry about it. It's just that.
So if Dave loses, he has to wear the Mike Myers hockey mask from the movie Halloween. Now, you know, drivers will tell you, phone calls change their lives. Well, the Blaneys received a phone call last winter. This certainly is going to change theirs because a gentleman called saying, I've got your dad's old sprint car from 1971. So guess what? That's the next winter project for the Blaney family.
We found a couple of your dad's roofs off his modified.
Okay. Yeah,
I was in the garage at grandma's house.
Right.
That was neat because I didn't think we had no idea that was up there.
No, there was lots of stuff up there. There was stuff up there from the 50s.
But no, I mean, it's just a cool find. I mean, we have one of Dad's cars from 97 out in the front that he did most of the work on, really. I mean, all the work in restoring it. And so it would be super cool to have one of Dad's old cars, my grandpa's old cars around, you know. So that'll be a fun project. I'm looking forward to hopefully doing it justice, that's for sure.
You schedule in some time, buddy. I'll be here.
The last time an Andretti won a championship on dirt and pavement throughout the season was 1969. I was 2 years old. Marco Andretti trying to do that tonight like his grandfather, Mario, so many years ago. Willie.
I got Marco Jet Set Andretti, the championship leader, going into the main event for the final race tonight. You and Newman have been playing a little cat and mouse.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely got me once, so I got him back twice.
which was a little greedy on my part, but I was really struggling with the back end. I think I must have taken the tires out is the only thing I could put my finger on, because I think I started really with a really good back end. I'm like, oh, we're going to play. This is going to be fun. And then I just faded big time. I couldn't get into the corner, couldn't get off the corner. So need a bit of a miracle balance-wise now, which, they're asking me what I want to do to the car. I don't know what to do to these things. I'll try to manipulate it from a driver's standpoint, but you can only do so much when you're backing it in. So hopefully we can get some rear grip.
You got a big fan club here. It's all yours, Lindsay.
Yeah, I just saw that fan club actually up on the hill. They're all cheering, so stay tuned for that. Bobby Labonte, Willie T loves to use nicknames. Is there a nickname for what you were like on the track out there?
Ice Cube.
What do you mean?
Well, my brother was named Iceman, and
true.
Tony Glover named me Ice Cube because I'm his little brother. I guess I'm a cube. I don't know.
That's true.
That's one of many nicknames I think I know.
All right, you start third in the main event. So tell us, what do you have for him out there? What have you learned so far tonight?
Yeah, well, Earl Pearson used to drive for me in a dirt late model for years, and he was the bottom feeder. He was the king of the bottom feeding. So I'm trying to take a lesson from him and just bottom feed it, run on the bottom, run against those white tires and stay there. So I don't know that I'm risky enough to go on the outside, I just don't know that I can do that, so I'm going to just kind of hang on the bottom and, try to stay out of trouble most I can and see what happens. So make a little air pressure adjustment and hope for the best.
Steady as she goes. All right. Yeah. Thanks, Bobby. Tomorrow, we've got a full afternoon of sports. It begins at 1 Eastern with some Summer Hoops action in the Big Three, followed at 3 Eastern by more live PGA Tour coverage of the 3M Open. That's all coming up tomorrow on CBS. Yoakum?
Well, the guy who always sets the benchmark every time we go to the dirt tracks in Season 1 and Season 2 is Tony Stewart. Marco looked pretty strong tonight. Who are you most concerned about here in the main event?
Everybody. I can't run with these guys tonight for some reason. We were really good in practice, and I've hit the fence in turn two. I've hit the fence on the backstretch and hit everything but the pace car so far. So we have thrown the kitchen sink at it and made every adjustment that we're allowed to make, and we'll see if we can get going forward here. Marco and Bobby and Ryan, they beat me both heat races, so We're gonna have to hope for a miracle to try to catch these guys.
All right, the excitement's getting ready to build here, Willie.
I'm with the Beer Baron.
Beer Baron,
Mr. Michael Waltrip, and he makes great beer. Tell me about tonight.
I was making great time. We had a good heat there, and then I jumped the cushion, and I think I got a. I don't think it's me, Willie, but I got a right front fender problem. Me and Flo have a relationship issue with that right front fender. Every time I get anywhere near the wall, it just pops off. So the boys have fixed it. I was very loose. They put a rubber in their left rear, let some air out, and told me to go get them.
Has anyone helped you with that fender?
Yes, I have. Look at my crack. Now, this wasn't any other driver's fault for a change. I didn't see anybody that I could blame that one, only except for me. But this track is so fun. It's a real challenge, though. Flat, and you think you got it going up top, and we were running really well up there, and then it just went away. Went back to the bottom, made good time, but you're telling me I got to shut up now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I got to go to Lindsay.
You should never tell him to shut up, but I am standing by with the Biff, so I'm certainly excited to hear what he has to say. Greg Biffle, your take on the night so far.
Well, it's been a fun night, and it's obviously been entertaining from this point of view. So I got inside of Paul Tracy, get down in the corner, and got really, really sideways. And then I got forced to the outside on the restart, so I had to follow. I was following Ryan there, Blaney, and so I had to go to school really fast and jump the cushion on the top and got in the fence. So hopefully I've got all that out of the way and I can work my way up in the main.
All right. Good luck to you, Biff. We have got much more to come here on the Camping World SRX series on CBS. Images of what we've seen so far, including the dirt. Stay tuned. We've got the main event coming up next. A superstar Saturday night just getting started. Welcome back to the Camping World SRX series. Well, this has been a blast. We've followed this racing series. Nearly every stop has been hot, not just in temperature, but also on the racetrack. The excitement, the fireworks. We began in steamy Pensacola, headed up that East Coast, hopping over to Nashville, and then making our way out west and then up north. A beautiful night here at Sharon Speedway in Eastern Ohio. Monday night at 10 Eastern, the world's top bull riders join forces in a competition like you have never seen before. We're excited to say that our Alan Bestwick will be part of that team as well. Catch watch the premiere of PBR Team Series on CBS Sports Network. We asked you who you thought was going to win the main event, and you have spoken. Chase Elliott, the bulk of you think that he's going to do exactly what he did last season, come in here and win the finale, so we'll see if that holds true. Ryan Newman is a close second, and if he does that, the championship is on the line for Ryan Newman. Dave Blaney, a strong favorite as well, and of course, Tony Stewart. You can never count out smoke. Time now to get these engines rolling. It's time for the main event. Alan Bestwick and Joey Logano up in the booth. Guys?
All right, Lynch, thanks. That's the sound we want to hear, is all 13 of these SRX cars firing up and coming back out onto the racetrack. And I know Joey was particularly relieved that both Chase Elliott and Ryan Blaney got through that first wreck, because if they were done for the night, he might be hitching a ride back to Pocono.
Oh, no. I was the chauffeur.
Oh, you were the chauffeur?
I was the rental car driver. I wheeled them right in here safely. I don't get to drive on the track, which I'm very jealous about right now. I'm having fun up here with you, don't get me wrong, but the track looks like a lot of fun. And no, I'm not worried about them leaving me. I got the keys in my pocket.
Always keep the keys. That's a championship move. So let's talk about the racing that you've seen so far and what you expect in this main event. Guys are racing for a championship. Guys are racing for a trophy, a feature win, which is what it's all about for these guys, to win the race.
Absolutely.
What are we
going to
see?
I think everyone's going out there, they're going to run hard. It's the last race for them for the season. They're going to get everything they can get out of it. The track is already shown to be a lot of fun. You heard that from every driver in between these, the heat races so far. They're all having a blast. They all realize the track is wide. We watched them water down the top lane a little bit. So we heard Dave Blaney talk about the top maybe going away. Well, they watered it down, so it should hang in there a little bit longer. We'll see how it progresses through the feature here.
And not only that, but they put a fresh set of tires on all the cars as well, which tires are always your best friend in a situation like this, as you see these cars beginning to work their way out. And just by the way, the pit area was supposed to be in the infield for tonight's race, but because of the rainstorm we had this afternoon, that's why they're working out of what's the garage area outside the racetrack. That's outside turn number 2 and rolling off the bank and back onto the back straightaway as the cars rejoin the speedway.
And you see Ryan Blaney coming back on the racetrack. Let's dial him up. Ryan Blaney, it's your chauffeur, Joey Logano. You got me?
Oh, I got you.
Well, you're back on track. Wrong place, wrong time in the beginning there. But you're back out there. Your old man's not too far ahead of you. We watched the specials here, and it was really, really cool seeing your dad and talk about his son racing on the same track. So we're hoping you get the chance to get up there and, well, I'd say beat fenders, but you don't have no fenders left on it. But it beat doors, at least.
Well, that's the beauty of it. I don't have to replace a fender if I beat it. Beat this fender too hard, so. Yeah, that stuck in the heat race. I thought we were going around the bottom pretty good. And wrong place, wrong time. But still really lucky to be in the race. Appreciate everybody coming out. Hopefully I can get up and race there with the old man here before it's too long.
Well, you can't hurt it much more, so hammer down, bud.
Yeah,
well, a frank assessment from Joey Logano to his pal and NASCAR teammate, Ryan Blaney. So, the average finish of the two heat races sets the starting lineup for the main event, so Ryan Newman is on pole position for our main event by winning the first heat and finishing fourth in the second. And how about Tony Kanaan, IndyCar guy, his only experience racing on dirt, running Tony Stewart's charity race at Eldora a couple times, and here in SRX. And here tonight, he finished fifth in the first heat and second in the second heat, and he's on the front row for the main.
Here's the bottom line. I don't care if you come from IndyCar or stock car. These guys are the best. These guys are amazing race car drivers, and if you have that much talent, give them a second. They will figure it out because they are just great race car drivers, and that's what makes it so neat, this SRX series, to see them all come together. Nowhere else can these guys ever race against each other in this style, where I wouldn't say really either side has a huge advantage. Maybe the stock car guys have a little bit of an advantage because of the car, but this is what makes SRX so cool, is that these guys actually get to race against each other, who they watch on TV every weekend.
So we're coming to the green flag for the main event. Format tonight, 70 green flag laps. Caution laps don't count tonight. And a championship in the SRX series is on the line tonight. The standings very close between Marco Andretti, Ryan Newman, and Bobby Labonte entering our main event. Tony Stewart and Greg Biffle with an outside shot at the championship also. 70 laps of racing at Sharon Speedway as our main event is underway. Green flag. And Ryan Newman right away into Tony Kanaan to squeeze him off.
All right, right off the bat, there's contact trying to get clear. But we talked about what being up front means. Having that clean air is important as you get going here. And Newman can set the pace now that he's out front. He can save his tires. 70 laps, you don't want to run hard every single lap. He can take care of his car a lot more than these guys trying to go through the field. I see Chase Elliott up top. Three wide. Rocking the top. He knows they watered the track up there. There's a little bit more moisture, a little bit more speed.
Flat right front tire on Paul Tracy's car. He's heading to the infield. He bounced off the outside wall, exiting turn two. That's what I said ooh about a minute ago. We stay under green as PT tries to make it back into the pit area. And second place is where the hot spot is now. Watch coming right at you here, right in front of the camera.
Oh, this is a big hit. Yeah, he's going to have more than just a right front tire flat. He got a pretty good clip here. He felt that one.
Yeah, he did.
That's a solid hit. No give in the walls here. No give in the right side when you hit it flush.
PT has taken that car outside to the pit area, outside the racetrack, just early in our main event. So it's Newman, Chase Elliott, Bobby Labonte, the first three. Then Marco Andretti, fourth. Tony Kanaan is faded back to fifth. And he's being worked on there by Michael Waltrip. This is Tony Stewart, who's back in eighth place, racing with Dave Blaney.
No surprise here. We saw Dave Blaney rock at the top in the heat race earlier tonight. You see him up there as well right now, trying to make the time while he can. I would assume the top's going to eventually go away, so he's trying to make all the time he can while he can.
Blaney, the co-owner of the Speedway, one of our local all-stars tonight.
Don't look too far back. His son Ryan Blaney is right there. I saw him a couple cars back.
So the race for second spot right now as Ryan Newman has gotten away. Bobby Labonte and Chase Elliott there. Elliott trying to hold off Labonte, who will settle down inside of him instead of running that high line into third place.
Newman is checked out for now. And like we said, the track's going to change, these cars are going to change, the tires are going to wear, things are going to keep changing. So even though you see Newman out there and he looks like he's set sail, things are looking good. We're 8 laps into this thing. So many things can change.
Yeah, a lot of racing still to go.
And you know there's going to be a caution in these dirt tracks. You've seen that happen a lot tonight and last week.
We know there'll be cautions no matter what, because that's how we roll here. Newman, Elliott, Labonte, the top three. They've gotten away a little bit from fourth place, who is now Marco Andretti. So you see Chase Elliott having reeled in Ryan Newman. Oh, got a car around at the back of the field. And we go caution here. As is that Hunter Ray that's up against the wall? No, it's Dave Blaney.
I wonder what happened there.
Jump the cushion.
Could be.
That's what it looked like.
Car looks okay, though.
It was a soft landing, much softer than the Paul Tracy hit we saw a little bit ago. So yellow flag is out. 9 of 70 laps are complete in our main event on Superstar Saturday night. Ryan Newman is the race leader. Dave Blaney is going to rejoin the tail end of the field.
We have to tell everyone that we just switched to Verizon's new Welcome Unlimited plan for just $30.
I've already told everyone.
Wait, did you say Verizon for just $30?
It's their best unlimited price ever.
$30? That's awesome.
Yeah, and it's from the most reliable 5G network in America.
For $30 a line, I'm switching now.
Yeah, it's easy. And you get $960 when you switch the whole family.
Oh, wow. I gotta let my buddies know.
We're already here.
The network you want, the price you love, only from Verizon.
The loyal lover
of riders. Riders, let your queries be known.
How come we don't call ourselves bikers anymore? I mean, riders is cool, but bikers, really cool.
Seriously?
Deny.
Can we go back to meeting at the rec center? The commute here is brutal.
Deny.
How do we feel about getting a quote to see if we can save with America's number one motorcycle insurer?
Should Flo stop asking the same question every time?
Approved!
Denied!
Whoa.
Hey, babe, meet us at the bottom of the trail.
Oh, man.
Open up the redesigned Chevy Silverado with a sophisticated high-tech interior.
Open the door.
It's easy to forget it's a truck.
Thanks.
Nice truck.
It was.
Find new style. Find new roads. Chevrolet.
Here's my dip.
Yes, sweet!
Did you bring me 7-layer dip?
Yeah, but it's just 7 layers of beans.
Resourceful. Or did you invite all your friends to watch your favorite team?
They're losing, but that's okay.
So sweet for you, really. Baby, there's nothing better. I bet you've probably done something that deserves a Dr. Pepper. Did you pretend to like sports or your girlfriend's dad would like you better?
What? No, I love sports.
Me too.
Everyone's done something that deserves a Dr. Pepper.
So what do you deserve?
Under the first caution of our main event on Superstar Saturday Night, after Dave Blaney spun off of turn number 2, this is On Board with Him.
It never hit the wall. Just got there. See, you see the dirt up there, how loose it is. That's where you get this. Oh, right rear a little bit too high and around she went. Shows how right on the edge you gotta be though when you're trying to run the top. You can be right on the edge of all that loose stuff to go fast, and you gotta be on the gas and sideways to go fast, but if you get a little bit too much, around she goes.
Is that that old saying of racing on the ragged edge?
That's it, right there.
Well, Dave Blaney, no contact with the wall. Now he's back there with his son Ryan toward the tail end of the field. And by the way, Paul Tracy has come back out from the pit area in that lavender-colored car and has rejoined the end of the field also.
How about how cool it must be? You're lining up to restart this race with all these legends of motorsports, and you're watching your son right in front of you.
Right?
How cool is that? That's got to be really neat.
Coming to the green flag with Ryan Newman and Chase Elliott on the front row. Elliott in red, Newman in navy blue, and the green flag is out.
Chase really able to hang on the outside. We didn't see that happen on the initial start. 3-1 and 2.
2-3 wide. Michael Waltrip backs out of it. Marco Andretti had Tony Kanaan inside of him and slipped in the corner. Who's that riding the rim? Is that Ryan Blaney behind there? Yeah.
Yes, it is.
The torn up white car. Making some ground on this restart. He's passed 3 of them.
Blaney's not afraid to send it. We've seen that happen quite a few times in the Cup Series. He'll make a big move, especially on these restarts.
Well, the pressure's on now, too. He wants to finish ahead of Dad, so Dad has to wear the mask at the Halloween party and all that.
Well, he's looking good so far. Look at him way up there. Oh, a little too high.
Ooh.
A little too high there.
Here's Greg Biffle inside of Ryan Blaney. Tony Stewart right behind Ryan, and Dave Blaney looking to the outside.
Father like son, right? The nut didn't fall too far from the tree on that one.
he doesn't want to lose that little bit either. Chase Elliott leading, Ryan Newman second, Bobby Labonte third, while we ride with Ryan Blaney back in traffic.
You see, look at how straight they're going. And it almost looks slow when they're going straight, but that's kind of the way you want it to be. You want to try to keep it straight so you can get drive off the corner. When a car is sideways and it has yaw on it, yeah, you might be able to go through the corner fairly quick. But when you get to right here to 2/3 part of the corner, you want to straighten it out so you can launch out of that corner.
We saw some of the guys who picked up the most ground in our main event so far. Here's the fun back here. Ryan Blaney in white, Tony Stewart in red. Dave Blaney will show up in and out of the frame in the black car to the right of the screen. And then Paul Tracy in lavender.
And that might be one of the biggest surprises we're talking about here tonight. Tony Stewart being so good on the dirt, especially in these SRX cars. We expect him to be up front, one of the favorites tonight. And he said it. Yeah. He said he's struggling. He's going to need a miracle to make this thing good enough. So different tracks ask for different things.
Tony Stewart has been the only winner in our 2 seasons of SRX racing on a dirt track coming into tonight.
Well, we may have a different winner tonight. We'll have to wait and see.
Take a look at some of our live telemetry on Tony Stewart. Heartbeats per minute, BPM.
Oh, cut the fence a little bit there. He able to get his hands in there. He's driving almost with one hand. He's got the wheel so much to the right, he's got to release his right hand to be able to do that. Blaney using the bumper. He doesn't have a bumper. That's not going to work out so well.
He can only get away with that so many times.
He's trying. Why isn't it working? There's nothing up there. Look, his hood's flat up. I wouldn't use it too much. There's not much there. Silva just kind of locked down right here. Here's the bump again. As he kind of gets in here. Oh.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Yeah. Oh, not enough. Didn't quite do it for him as he's trying to get underneath Biffle. And that might be one of the only ways you can pass once these guys all get locked down at the bottom. You might have to give him a little nudge.
Now, a traffic jam in front of him.
Oh,
Michael Waltrip got a nudge from Greg Biffle. Good save, Mikey.
Blaney saw that as an opportunity to go to the top and try to carry momentum around Waltrip. This is going to get tight.
There's Matt Kenseth, Ryan Hunter-Reay, and then Waltrip and Biffle get clear. Ryan Blaney had to back out of it and lost some ground. Stewart to the outside, still trying to find some running room. He does the crossover on Hunter-Reay. Excuse me, coming through.
Here's where they're three wide off of turn two here. Blaney up top. Gets a little checked up. His dad ran into him. Looked like Ryan knew he was about to get fenced right here by Michael Waltrip, so he checked up and his dad was right there. And a little contact. It's okay.
It's fiberglass, the body panels on these cars, so it's not like a piece of metal that was dropped on the racetrack. I don't know if that hood's going to make the end of this main event on that Ryan Blaney car, but he's sure out there wheeling it.
He said the heck with it. He's keeping his front tires nice and cool. I'm sure it's not helping him. You know, you may say they're going slow, downforce doesn't matter. I'm telling you, you're going fast enough. You put your hand out the window going down the highway going 40 or 50, and you can play the airplane game.
Oh, yeah.
There's downforce being made, or not being made, on Blaney's car right now.
So Ryan Newman running in second position. He's about 5-6 car lengths behind Chase Elliott and one or so ahead of Bobby Labonte. Check out the miles an hour. You were talking about you're still going fast enough, right?
Yeah, and you see it, 55 miles an hour in the middle of the corner. You're not going much faster than that down the straightaway. But what I like watching is his hands. You know, you see him steering a fair amount. That's not a lot for dirt. He's keeping it fairly straight, trying to keep the car to where it's driving off the right front tire, not the right rear tire.
Tony Stewart starting to get it rolling. Smoke is up to fifth position in that red number 14. Riding the rim on the outside. Marco Andretti next in line ahead of him.
See Marco on the bottom there. Tony up top. See, most of these guys are all on the bottom. Except for Tony. Yeah, that's a great shot of it. He's pretty much the only one up there. There's something I don't know.
If the bottom lane is all clogged up, you got to find some place to pass. Right?
Go where they're not.
Now, I know as a currently active race driver, it's maybe against your natural instincts to talk to somebody under the green flag. But this is SRX. We're used to this by now, so.
Oh, I think it's kind of cool. Let's do it. Let's try it. Tony Stewart, Joey Logano up here in the booth. You got me?
Yeah, what's happening there, Spoon?
Well, it looks like you're cruising around. You're riding the top. Most guys are on the bottom. I figured you must know something I don't know. What are you thinking up there?
Well, you know me. I'm not very good at that thinking part, but kind of got going up here. I mean, I can roll the bottom pretty decent, but doesn't seem like anybody's really up here anymore. So got to go where they're not. You know, it's the easiest way to get around, but just got to catch some moisture at the right place.
But you're much better than me. I can't talk and drive, so stay focused in there.
Thanks, bud. Glad you're with us tonight.
It's like a Sunday drive. Nothing's going on. I know one thing. If I start talking on the radio while I'm racing, it's an instant 0.2 of a second each lap, for sure. I am good at one thing at a time. That's it.
Well, big respect to Tony, who's always, he says, anytime, give us a call.
Give us a call.
So, lead tightened up a little bit here as Newman had tracked down Chase Elliott. He was within maybe a car length. Now he slipped back just a little bit, but he's not going away.
No, not at all. You see, you can see on the bottom of the racetrack, there's a little bit of moisture right there by the big tires they have there. And that's what those guys are doing. They're searching for that moisture. They're trying to keep the car nice and straight to be able to hook it both at the left front and the left rear.
Got caution out. There's a car that stopped up against the outside wall in turn three. And it is Dave Blaney, who has had some trouble and is rolling
right
slowly.
Front.
Is the right front down on that car?
Yes, it is.
Well, that's a problem.
Right front fender's coming off as well, so maybe a little something happened here. Here's a replay. See, Dave.
Ooh, that'll do it.
Fence just a little bit. That's all it took. And you can see the car kind of fall down on the right front right after that.
So second caution of our main event tonight with 40 laps to go in the series finale for this summer from the Superstar Racing Experience. Torn up our share of cars again on this dirt track.
Get up, get moving, and gradually reduce grays the easiest way. Just step into the shower with Just for Men Control GX Shampoo. The first and only shampoo that blends away a little gray with every wash for a subtle, natural look. Control GX from Just for Men.
This pepperoni was carefully placed by hand by a pizza maker at Papa John's. Just like this one, and that one over there. Ooh, and even these in the crust. Get yourself the new epic pepperoni stuffed crust pizza, only at Papa John's.
When you hear best-in-class range or best-in-class fuel economy, you may be thinking of really tiny cars. And you'd be really, really wrong. The Ram 1500. Exceeding expectations. Again. No wonder more people are switching to Ram than ever before.
Every dollar counts these days, so take advantage of this great offer from Ram Trucks.
RV to escape. Escape the humdrum of daily life. Escape your routine. Escape to your sunnier side. At Sun Outdoors, you're free to do, well, anything. Free to drift here or splash there. Free to turn happy hour into nature hour and back to an even happier evening. There are over 150 Sun Outdoors resorts. Escape to your sunnier side at any one of them.
It's true. Everyone gets a free new Samsung Galaxy S22 with a Galaxy trade-in. Any year, any condition.
Really? Even if my old phone looks like this?
Dude, why?
Good. It's okay, people. I've trained for this.
It's not complicated. New and existing customers get a free new Samsung Galaxy S22 with the Galaxy trade-in. Any year, any condition.
The streaming wars continue in South Park, and there's one place to see the action. Watch South Park The Streaming Wars Part 2, now streaming exclusively on Paramount Plus. Eavesdrop a little bit on Tony Stewart's radio.
Looks like it's rolling pretty good around the top here. Anybody else up there trying it? Only you. That's right. I'm sticking with it. I just got to get back up there. 10-4. Doing good.
Well, I told him that when we talked to him. I said, you were the only ones up here. He didn't believe me up here.
Well, you know, just regrouping his position since he's down on the inside line for this restart. Dave Blaney's car, new right front tire. He's back on the track, tail end of the field. And we are ready for a restart. Chase Elliott in red inside. Ryan Newman in blue on the outside. And the flag on the starter stand is green.
Leo Newman, good start up top. And this is how Chase ended up with the lead. Kind of rolls reverse this time, though. Newman's going to try to pinch him down on the tires. And look at that, Marco Andretti. trying to make a run up top as well.
Bobby Labonte inside of him in the white car. So side by side by side by side.
And I know Newman's going to try to keep him pinched down the bottom. That's going to be what's going to hold Chase from being able to accelerate off the corner. He's going to try to pinch him here. This is a good race.
Elliott in red, Newman in blue, Andretti in orange, Labonte in white. Little contact in that second row. Here comes the... Oh, caution. Got a piece of debris up high in turn number two that's come off one of the cars and is a safety concern. So the yellow flag is out. There it is.
Oh, it is, right?
Piece of metal.
Yeah. Yeah, bracket of some sort. There's been some contact between these cars,
yes,
I'm sure.
Yes, there has been.
Look at these guys are racing so hard. Andretti giving a little bump to the Newman. That's when you're wondering if you're Andretti, where do I go? Which lane do I want to be in?
Then he got bumped by Labonte and got shoved up into the outside lane.
I think eventually you're going to want to be on the bottom, but it looks like you have three or four laps you can run door to door.
Something to be concerned about. Look at the grill on Marco Andretti's car. It's all kind of punched in from some of that contact, so they'll be keeping an eye on that to make sure that that radiator opening doesn't get clogged up with dirt.
And I think it's going to take a lot for Marco Andretti to give up the position he is running in. He's racing for a championship. And as they run, he's only got it by 2 points over the car right in front of him, Ryan Newman. So it's a pretty close battle right there.
It's a very close battle. And it's a lot of fun. So the restart order being called out to the drivers from race control, and then they'll give them a two-to-go signal, and we'll get ready to go back racing in our main event with still a little over half of the feature to go. What do you think so far?
I think the old pace car is making some laps, probably make some more laps here. Randy LaJoy's in that thing. How about that? That's pretty cool. A lot of racing laps there as well. And maybe the coolest pace car in all of motorsports. Look at that thing.
talk to Randy about that. It took him a while to learn how there's a sequence to firing that thing up. You got to go through to launch it, but it's a lot of fun.
I'm sure it took a while to train him because his ability to focus more than 5 seconds isn't really there. He would agree with that.
Here we come to the restart. Chase Elliott has chosen the outside lane. Ryan Newman is on the inside lane. Andretti and Labonte side by side in row number two. Stewart again trapped out of that inside lane. Everybody wanting to know, how is it going to turn out?
Oh, my goodness.
Andretti hits Newman and spins him. Yellow flag.
And so we just talked about the championship right before this, and that was the two cars racing for the championship.
Yep.
And Andretti really center in there. Let's take a look at this again. Look at the just drove through Newman. And he got damage on the right front as well. I'd say it wouldn't really worked out for anybody. And he saw a gap and tried to take it. That was Chase is definitely his biggest competition was Ryan Newman for sure. That was my reaction in the booth as well.
Wow. Yes, it did happen that way.
Jaw-dropping moments here.
Yeah. So the top two guys in the standings tangle. And now we'll be back toward the tail of the field. Newman got away more quickly. I'm curious to see how they position this for the restart.
I was wondering if they just blend back in or what. And we see Andretti down here in the pits.
How about it, Matt?
the SRX crew going to work, jacking up the right side of that number 98 machine. They're going to get the right front off. You can see how the body damage is tucked up underneath, and that's why it was locked up. We saw that last week when we were at I-55 a couple different times. They've got a piece of bare bond you can see in the shot right now that they're going to possibly use to piece back together that right front fender. A lot of work going on. Like you mentioned, I mean, he sent it in there, Joey.
He definitely did. And well, we've seen him do this all night long in the heat races on the restarts. He did it again on this restart.
Well, trouble in turn one on a restart between the top two of the championship. Things get more interesting.
I didn't win the lawsuit, but everybody knows I wrote that song.
Flo? Gosh, it's been forever. You look fantastic. It's John. Ham, from the blind date we went on years ago?
Ah, the struggling actor who didn't believe he could save his snapshot based on how and how much he drives.
I'd love to talk about it over dinner sometime.
Well, I usually don't talk on the phone during dinner, but for potential customer Tom Ham, I will make an exception.
Oh, boy.
Can I get it mic'd away? What's happening? Your free sub. Enjoy.
Thanks. That was super weird.
Oh, that?
Nah.
She just used the shore points you can now earn from chip and drink purchases to get free sub through the app. Download the Jersey Mike's app and earn rewards towards free subs with every sub, Pepsi, and Lazy purchase.
Our passion for protecting vehicles started in 1934. And we've been pushing the limits of performance ever since. Innovate with the times and have the trusted filters to fit your needs. Yeah, we've been around the block, but our journey is just beginning. Fram for the road ahead. Find Fram True Air Premium Cabin Air Filters at Walmart.
Camp for less at Camping World. We're your one-stop shop for camping and RV supplies. Right now, we have a two-pack of camp chairs for $39, Coleman coolers for 50% off, and a Coleman grill, normally $319, now just $199. Have fun at the campground with 40% off all Coleman mini bikes and save $60 on this fire pit. Plus, you can take home a brand new RV for less than $5 a day. Camping has never been more affordable. You'll always camp for less at Camping World.
Camping World SRX series on CBS Sports is sponsored by Fram, trusted since 1934, and by Progressive. Save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance.
Well, what a beautiful sight. A sellout crowd here at Sharon Speedway in northeastern Ohio, right on the Ohio-Pennsylvania border. And our last incident involved the top three in the championship.
It has changed everything, because there you see Bobby Labonte in that white car on the bottom in the front row as the championship leader at the moment as they run. So big turn of events there on that restart. And now you have a new front row. Bobby Labonte hasn't been up there tonight that we've seen, but we also saw that last restart. He's right there in the hunt. And it seems like his car and the track is kind of coming to his liking.
Kind of curious, Chase Elliott, the race leader, chose the outside lane for the restart. So it's Labonte inside of Chase Elliott, then Matt Kenseth inside of Tony Stewart in the second row, and Marco Andretti back at the tail end of the field in 13th position as we come to the green flag.
Big start by Chase, not a good start by Bobby at all. See a top three cars on the top were able to clear.
Here's Hunter Ray to the outside, Labonte and Kenseth to his inside as Tony Stewart launches to the outside of Chase Elliott for the race lead.
Never count smoke out, right? He said his car is no good. He kind of found something up top, was cruising up there, and now look at him making a run to the outside of Chase Elliott. Tony kind of pulls it down a little bit. He doesn't run the full radius up top. Chase recognized this, meaning he's watching in the mirror because there's no spotters. Remember, so Chase watched Tony do that and said, I better change what I'm doing. I'm about to get past. Smoke goes where he's not. Back to the bottom.
Oh, slide jump.
What a slider.
So Tony Stewart to the front gets a big cheer from this big crowd here at Sharon Speedway. Now Chase Elliott in second with Matt Kenseth in third. Ryan Hunter Ray in fourth. And Bobby Labonte shuffled back to fifth.
Isn't it? Look how Smoke gets the lead here. Look at him go down to the bottom, carrying momentum, and said, yeah, that's my right rear bumper. I got to take that.
The guy that said he couldn't get anything going for a large measure of the night in the two heat races now has the race lead. But here comes Chase Elliott back, looking to make that bottom lane work for him.
Two different theories once again. Top versus bottom, how long the top lasts and how this works. Smoke's been able to make it work for him for a while here this whole race so far.
Toward the back end of the field, Michael Waltrip and Tony Kanaga tangled up off of turn four. They've continued. We stay under green. How much fun do you think these two guys are having racing like this?
I think they're having a blast right now. It looks like they're having so much fun. We've said this all night, how slick the track is, right? Easy on the throttle, not much speed at all, right? We saw 55 miles an hour in a center and a corner. They're not going fast, but they're right on the ragged edge because we're seeing cars spin out all by themselves. So you know they're right on the edge, although they're not really going that fast. It makes it really fun when you're inside the race car doing that. And it's a lot of fun for us to watch.
Yeah, and think about it, right? They're maybe not going 200 miles an hour, but for the conditions, they're right on the edge of it.
No one said you had to go 200 miles an hour to put on a good race.
That's right.
These guys are putting on a great race at the speeds they're running. And look at Chase, still all over Tony. Tony moving around back down to the bottom. Anywhere you want to go out here, every option is open for this racetrack right now. Oh!
There's a time, jumping the cushion on the outside and losing some ground. Is Chase Elliott. He gathered it up without hitting the wall significantly.
He's just getting a little bit on the high side and,
Well, maybe hit it more significantly than I thought.
I think that's okay. It didn't look too bad to me.
So there is a time limit on the main event, and we hit the point where that's going to get put into play. So the drivers were just told there are 10 laps to go in the main event. 10 green flag laps left in the main event.
Well, you better go. Not much time at this point. There's Matt Kenseth, who's made a great run, doing it Kenseth style. Just there at the end, out of nowhere. You don't talk about him all day, and then he pops up.
Yeah.
That's the typical Matt Kenseth we're all used to. And here he is, just creeping into the pitcher at the end of the race.
Caution flag as Tony Kanaan is going around in turn number four. Yellow flag is out. And that resets everything.
And we didn't really need to reset anything because the racing has been fantastic here at Sharon Speedway. And now it's going to get even more intense, though, that the wind's there. And these guys have not much to lose.
Here's what happened to Tony Kanaan.
Ooh, got that tire. And we talked about it. Even though you're not going fast, you're on the ragged edge. That was a great example of that. That big tire didn't do much damage to his race car. Those things are heavy. You know, you don't want to hit those things. Yeah, they move, but they're really heavy. And they've been there for a while, so some dirt kind of piles up around them.
Yeah. So they get in the field, ordered properly for the restart, and doubled up. And by the way, back in the picture all of a sudden, keep an eye on Dave Blaney, third car back, inside row. He was riding that rim on the outside. Remember, he was way back at the tail end of the field? He's in fifth.
He's made something happen, huh?
Yeah.
That is pretty awesome.
And big salute to Ryan Hunter Ray on the outside in the other black car. Think about this. Ryan never, ever raced on dirt until last Saturday night.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Well, we got a minute here. Let's check in with the second place runner, Chase Elliott. Chase Elliott, Joey Logano up here in the booth. You've run the top, you've run the bottom. Tony pulled a heck of a slider. What's the game plan on the restart here? Uh-oh. Chase Elliott, Joey Logano, you got me here? He doesn't want to talk to me.
Well, or...
I figured he's going to use the right front fender like he used me up last week. So I figured he's probably going to know that playbook pretty well.
Yeah.
This Bill. Bill flew with us from Pocono earlier today. So we had a fun plane ride over here talking about the changes in NASCAR over the years.
Oh, yeah.
So lots of different things, and it's cool to get Bill's perspective.
All right, so we're coming to the green flag. The two red cars on the front row. Stewart inside, Elliott outside. It's Matt Kenseth and Ryan Hunter-Reay in row two. Then Dave Blaney and Bobby Labonte in row three. Ryan Blaney is in the outside of the next row, looking to see if he can pass old dad, too.
See, Tony sent it in there pretty hard. He's trying to slide up the racetrack in front of Chase. Chase is going to get a run off the corner here, trying to cross him back.
Here we go.
And now will Chase repay the favor? Yes, he will, as he slides back up in front of Smoke.
Crash behind him.
Hunter-Reay, looked like Newman got involved in that one a little bit.
Yellow flag is out again. Marco Andretti got a piece of something also in the crash. May have another right front down on his car. Well, great racing up front, but the guys out back, Michael Waltrip's dragging a duct hose behind his car.
A brake hose of some sort. Hunter-Reay looks like he is not moving, I can tell you that much, but looks like it might be broke.
Let's see what happened. He's on the outside. That's Marco to his inside. Oh, no, that's further ahead. That's Dave Blaney.
Like Dave got into Hunter-Reay there maybe a little bit somehow. And we got a piece of that at the end. Oh, Newman hit it pretty hard, actually.
Yeah, I want to see the whole thing again.
Oof. That's a big hit to the right front. You see how it's not steering either. He goes right back up the racetrack. So Andretti's car definitely hurt. Rest of the fender off it now.
I still need a better read on what actually started that whole thing for me to get Hunter-Reay sideways.
Yeah, I'm not sure either.
Yeah. Marco's car is for wear.
Well, and as we said, he's racing for that championship, and you know he's trying everything he can do to get himself back up to the front, and we'll see what happens if he get that thing back out there and how this whole thing shakes out at the end. See everyone under caution. They're all fighting for position. They don't know where to be. Get to the restart. There's so many cars as a cluster. Everyone's trying to figure out where they need to be.
Tower's calling it out to them. They all are all on a radio channel. It's kind of like a you're too young to remember, like a party line phone. But they're all on one channel. Race Control can talk directly to the drivers, as can we.
But the drivers can't talk back to Race Control, because no. I think that would be a mess.
It would be a disaster.
Well, here we go here.
That waved off the restart. First of all, Marco Andretti just came back out of the pits.
And how about Ryan Blaney up there in the fourth position? What?
Yeah, well, on that last restart, while we were watching Chase and Tony, right, he went to the outside, three wide, around a couple guys.
And now he's got a shot at it.
And missed the wreck. And that car is the worst for wear.
That one's hurt. Oh, yeah. It looks like they're putting him back somewhere else. He's trying to sneak a couple spots there.
Well, I think where the caution came out and how they do all that. And there's poor Marco's car.
He's back out there, but he's still in the championship lead at the moment.
It started as an orange car. Now it's kind of mostly... I was going to say mostly black duct tape, but that's actually, there's nothing there at all.
He took that off.
Yeah.
He took a pretty big shot to the right front. You know, they cut off the fender, so there's no reps, but
yep.
I'm pretty sure it probably knocks the toe out, the front end alignment, amount in those heads.
Tony or Chase, who do you like?
I mean, it's hard not to go against Tony Stewart on a track like this, but man, those slide jobs back and forth were a lot of fun to watch, and it's going to happen again on this restart.
Here we go.
Tony on the bottom as as I say, it's going to happen again. He's creeping the bottom, trying to wrap it to get the launch off the corner. Oh, not quite going to get him. Chase hanging strong up top. This is so much patience. You want to send it in there and carry so much more speed, but you got to be so disciplined to make sure you don't overrun the corner. Whether you're Tony or Chase in this position, you got to be so disciplined not to make a mistake as you're racing for the lead with only 8 to go.
Elliott trying to roll the outside. Stewart protecting the bottom.
Tony might get him off the corner this time. Looks like he had a little bit more distance. Tony's not even wanting to use the whole racetrack here.
Meanwhile, Bobby Labonte trying to find a way around Ryan Hunter-Reay to keep himself in the thick of this. And Marco Andretti and Ryan Newman trying to charge from the back.
And there's Kenseth again. Takes a couple laps for him to get going, but he's great in the mix of this as well.
Look at Marco hanging it out, doing everything he can to try and make up some ground. 6 laps to go in our SRX series for the summer of 22. Side by side again for the race lead. Stewart inside, Elliott outside.
Elliott's really figuring out the top here. Look at the momentum he's gonna carry. He's gonna clear smoke up top here. Now, does Tony change what he's doing at this point, right? Chase is up there, he's fast. He's faster than what Tony is right now. Do you change it up, or do you stay married to what you're doing?
What about if you're Chase? Do you stay on that outside, or do you come protect the bottom?
It's working for you. Don't change. You're faster than the competitor behind you. You have to stay doing what you're doing.
Coming to 3 laps to go, as Elliott and Stewart fight for the race win. Just can't quite hook it up now. Elliott goes to the bottom. Stewart slides wide.
Now, is that the right thing or is that a mistake? That's a last-minute little change there on the line change.
So here they come to 2 laps to go.
I think that was probably a pretty good move on Chase's part. It looks like it worked out pretty well as he's pulling away a little bit from Tony.
Matt Kenseth in the blue car down the bottom trying to fight for second.
As those two are battling, Chase is checking out.
Ryan Newman running 8th, Marco Andretti running 9th. But the focus is up front. White flag is out. 1 lap to go for Chase Elliott. Matt Kenseth left to fight with Stewart for second spot as Elliott has checked out 3-4 car lengths. Come to their feet. Checkered flag comes out from the starter stand. And a win in his second try at SRX is Chase Elliott. He wins tonight in Ohio. Stewart edges Kenseth for second. And Chase Elliott is 2 for 2 in visiting the Superstar Racing Experience.
I want to run every week. This is pretty fun for them. You know, it's fun watching them, you know, come over here on the airplane from Pocono. They're talking about the race car and not knowing what the heck's going to happen. Chase and Blaney, Ryan Blaney go out there together and have a practice later from everybody because they miss hot laps. And then they come around and eventually wins the race. And there's Marco Andretti.
There is your champion of the SRX series this year by 2 points over Ryan Newman. Marco Andretti is the SRX champion.
And I think that was a lot more of an eventful night that he was looking for. There was moments where he was 3rd in the championship standings. There was moments he was in the lead. He ultimately wins the championship. Ryan Newman missing it by 2 points.
Going to hear from our winner and our champion in a moment. Joey Logano, so much fun to have you with us tonight. Your thoughts on what you've seen?
I've had a blast. Congratulations to all these racers, SRX Series, for doing what they've done here. Sharon Speedway for putting on an amazing racetrack. We saw great racing all the way through the field, all the way down to the last lap. I had a blast. Thanks for having me here.
No, it was great to have you with us. Tony Stewart with the thumbs up to both Chase Elliott and Marco Andretti. And this sellout crowd will let out a big roar when these guys climb from their cars. Great fun tonight. Think about the night it was for Marco Andretti, right?
Oh, my goodness.
The beating that that car took, and back in the pit area, and the desperation to get from the back of the field up into a position where he could barely hold the championship. All right, here comes the race winner, Chase Elliott, and Matt Yoakum is there.
Raised his fist to the crowd, gave a big thumbs up to Marco Andretti. Two for two, two completely different nights, Nashville and here at Sharon Speedway. What means most to you about how you raced tonight? You and Tony Stewart, the bottom back up top. It was a great show. What means the most to you about it?
Well, to sit there and race on dirt with one of my heroes there in Tony Stewart and throw a couple sliders. With him, obviously, this is a little different than the open wheel stuff, but just knowing how good he is, you know, at this stuff and being able to dice it up with him, you know, and race with him. I actually thought he was better than me that run before, and then I was able to watch him on the top and finally get a couple things going there. But congrats to Marco. I hope he's okay. I don't know, something up, but nonetheless, great crowd. Thanks, everybody, for coming out tonight, and thanks to the Blaneys for having me up here.
When he began racing go-karts, he wanted to go number 20 for his hero, Tony Stewart, but he went number 9 because his dad paid the tire bill. Great night here in Sharon, Willie.
Okay, I had to run over here like a fan to catch the champ. You talk about hang in there award. You just kept coming back. Like the Energizer Bunny, man. Congratulations.
Yeah, the cool thing about this is you get damaged, you still can play and stay on the lead lap. So I broke my wrist in that last little thing. I got my thumb caught in the wheel. So that was a painful last couple laps, but I just wanted to cover and finish right where I needed to finish. And we were able to do that. So this thing was pretty robust tonight.
Oh, yeah, no, it's got beat up a little bit, but hey, you're the champ. That's all that matters.
Thank you, man.
Lindsay.
He said he wanted to prove that he could play in the sandbox, and indeed he did. Next on 48 Hours, did Chad Daybell play any role in killing the killing of his new wife's two children? His children speak out. 48 Hours next on CBS. A phenomenal night here at Sharon Speedway. We appreciate you spending some of your summer Saturday nights with us. For our crew, Alan Beswick, Joey Logano, Connor Daly, Willie T. Ribs, Matt Yoakum, producer Pam Miller, director Jim Cornell, and the CBS crew that works tirelessly behind the scenes. Thanks for watching. Here's a look back at a memorable 6 weeks.
Experience in Music City.
Tonight, a little slice of dirt racing heaven.
The